How can you identify anagrams easily? You are given some strings and you want to group all of the anagrams together, right? The output should be a list that has all of these anagrams grouped together. I will show you two different methods to solve this problem and get it accepted. If you want a quick solution and you just want to see the code, you can refer to the link in the description below to my GitHub profile. However, if you want to see how I came up with the solution, welcome back to Study Algorithms, a place where I simplify programming for you with animations, visuals, and some really easy to understand examples. Today, we would be solving a problem on LeetCode. The problem we would be solving today is group anagrams. First, I will describe you the problem statement and show you some sample test cases. Then, we will try to solve this problem by categorizing using sorting. I will also show you a second solution where you can categorize using the frequency of characters. Going forward, I will do a dry run of the code so that you can see how all of this actually works. So, without further ado, let's get started. The problem here is pretty straightforward. You are given an array that has some strings, and you want to group all of the anagrams together. All you need to know is what are anagrams. So, two strings are basically said to be anagrams if they are made up of the same number of characters. If you look at the word listen and the word silent, you can see that they have the same characters and the frequency of each character is also same. So, silent is formed from S, I, L, E, N, and T. And in the word listen also, you can find the same characters, right? And hence, silent and listen are said to be anagrams of each other. Now, to understand the problem even better, we can go over some sample test cases. Let us look at our first test case. You have an array of some strings, and the first string is eat. This string is formed from the letters E, A, and T. If you look closely in the array, what other strings can you find that have the same characters? You can see that T also has the same characters E, A, and T, and 8 also has the same characters A, T, and E, right? So, this looks like one group. If you look more, you can see that you have a string T, A, N, and you can find one more string N, A, T. This also has the same characters as T, A, N, right? So, this would be another group. If you look at the remaining string, that is BAT, that is a group in itself. So, in your resultant output, you can find three groups. You would have one group that only has BAT, you would have a second group that has NAT and TAN, and in the third group, you would have 8, EAT, and T. So, what you did is, you grouped all of these anagrams together, right? Similarly, in our test case number 2, if you see, I have the word eat and T. They have the same characters, right? And hence, they form a group. So, even in my resultant output, I have this as a group. It is not necessary that you can only have 3 characters. If you see, I have more anagrams in here. The word cars and scar also have the same characters, and hence they also form a group. A single letter is a group in itself, right? And hence you have the third group of a single letter A. And hence, once again, you were able to group all of your anagrams. In our test case number 3, that is kind of an edge case. Your input is empty, and hence your output will also be empty. That is because you weren't able to find any groups, right? That seems very obvious also. Now, a brute force solution to this problem is very obvious. You can try to take up every string and compare if it is an anagram of the other, and then form all of your groups. But this will take up a time complexity of order of n square. However, we want to improve it, right? So, let us see how we can go about doing it. To come up with a solution to this problem, we need to take advantage of the fact that we need to find anagrams. And we want to find what properties of anagrams can we use to our advantage. So, if I take up my original example of the words silent and listen. These both are anagrams, remember? That means these two strings have the same characters and the same frequency. So if I sort both of them, then they should look alike, right? So if I sort silent, it becomes something like this. And if I sort the word listen, then it becomes something like this. So you can see that after sorting, voila, I am able to see the same string, right? So can we use this property to our advantage? Let us see what we can do. You know that you have to group all of these anagrams, right? So I am taking a map where I can group all of these strings. So for the key part or the left column of my hash map, I would be taking a sorted string, and for my values, I would be having these groups. How do we populate this hash map? Let me start off with the first string, that is eat. So I sort this word. As soon as I sort eat, I will get the word A, E, and T. This is sorted, right? So what I do is I check my map. If I cannot find this word in my key, I add this as a key. And I add the corresponding string for which I got this result. So you see, I added one string to my hash map. Going forward, I take up my next string, that is T. I will again try to sort it. As soon as I sort it, it becomes A, E, and T. Now, you will try to look up this sorted string in your map. This time, you can find it over here, right? So, what you do is, you add up this string in your values. So, T would be added over here. Correct? Going forward, I get my third string, that is tan. Now, if I sort this, it becomes A, N, T. Right? Again, you will try to look up this string in your hash map. You can't find it. So what I simply do is, I add up A, N, T over here. And I will add the corresponding string to my group. Notice that in the keys, I am just putting the sorted string. Because when you sort these anagrams, they should turn out to be the same, right? And you will use this property to group all of them. Once again, when you move ahead, you see the word 8. If I will sort it again, it will become A, E, and T. I can find this again in my hash map, so I simply add A, T over here. Moving forward, I see the word NAT. Sorting it changes to A, N, T. I can find it in my hash map, so I add this word over here. And now for the last word, I see BAT. Sorting it changes into A, B, T. I cannot find it in my hash map, so I add it over here and I add the corresponding word in here. And hence, you see, I was able to find out all of my groups. And you need to return this list of strings as your answer. Note that the time complexity of this solution would be order of n log k, where k is the length of the maximum string and n is the number of strings. That is because you are sorting these strings, right? And if you try to implement this solution, you will get an accepted answer. However, we can still improve this. Let us see how. You see how we were able to take advantage of the fact that you need to find anagrams. So we are leveraging properties of anagrams. You know that anagrams would have the same characters, right? But also, if two strings are anagrams, then the frequency of those characters is also same. And we can take advantage of this fact. Suppose we have these two strings, knee and keen. These two are anagrams, right? You can see that they're formed from the same characters, right? But if you also notice that in these two strings, you have two E's, one K and one N. And can we take advantage of this property to categorize all of our anagrams? Let us see what we can do. Once again, I am creating a hash map where I would be grouping all of these strings together. But how to fill up this map? Let us take up our first string, that is AAB. So if you look closely, this string has two A's and one B. So I can say A to B1, and this can be a frequency string because it is telling me that I have two A's and one B in the string. So just like our previous method, what I can do is I can put up this string in my keys A to B1 and add the string that I found. Right? Going forward, I have my second string ABA. In this string also, you can see that you have two A's and one B. So I again got my same frequency string. I found this in my map. So I add this string also to my values. So you see, now we are forming groups. Going over to my third string, somehow I have the same frequencies again. I have two A's and one B. And I will use this frequency string to search my map. I can find this in my keys. So I add this value also to my map. Going ahead to our last value. If I create a frequency string out of this, it turns out to be A1, B2, and C3. Now, I can't find this string in my frequency map, right? So I will add this A1, B2, and the corresponding string in my values, right? So you see, this is how once again we are forming groups. Let us say I had two more strings in my original input array. Now, what happens if I try to create frequency strings of my new elements? So this turns out to be A1, B2, and this turns out to be A1, B2, C3. Right? If you look at our hash map again, you can't find A1, B2. So you would add A1, B2 in here and the corresponding string. And you can find A1, B2, C3 in your frequency map. And hence, you will write down the corresponding string for your values. So you see, once again, I was able to group all of these anagrams together, and this will be your answer. Notice that you can find this frequency string in a time complexity of order of k, where k is the length of the largest string. And if you have n strings, then you need an additional time complexity of order of n. And hence, the total time complexity of this solution would be order of n multiplied by k. You can argue that this solution would be a little faster because you are not sorting your strings over here. If this solution is now clear to you, let us do a dry run of the code and see how this works. To understand the dry run, let me take up an example array where we would be grouping all of these anagrams. On the left, you have the actual code to group all of these anagrams using the frequency method. So you have your input parameter strings. That is an array of strings. Next, you check your edge cases. If you're passing in an empty array or you don't have any strings. Going forward, we create a frequency strings hash map. So in this map, we would be storing the frequency string and all of the values as a key value pair, correct? Going forward, I start a for loop that will iterate over each of the element in your array. So you start off with your first string AAB. Next, you pass in this string as a parameter to a function to generate the frequency string. I will tell you in a bit how this frequency string is generated. But you already know from our methods that for the string AAB, the frequency string would be generated as A to B1. Going forward, we check if this frequency string is present in the map. Since it is not present, what I do is I create a new list and I add my original string to this list. And then I place my frequency string as a key value pair and the list that I created in my map. Right? Going forward, this loop will run again, and this time it will create a frequency string for BBA. The frequency string generated would be A1, B2. It cannot find in the map, and hence A1, B2 would be added, and a new list would be formed with the string BBA in it. In the third iteration, I get the string BAA. Once again, it will generate a frequency string. And this time, the frequency string generated would be A2 B1 again. You can find this in your map, right? And hence, you simply add this string to your frequency map. So you see, this is how your entire map would be populated. And once this process is done, at the very end, you return all of these values as your answer. So this is how you can solve it. Now, how did we create a frequency string? Let me show you quickly. Let us say I have this string AABCB and I want to generate a frequency string, right? You know that its frequency string should be A2, B2, C1, right? So what happens is this string is passed in as a parameter. Next, what we do is we create a frequency bucket. This is an array that is initialized to 0 initially. And each of the element is basically storing the frequency of each character. Going forward, we iterate over each character of this string. So what we basically do is we see the letter A. Now, A can be treated as 0, right? So this changes to 1. Next, you see A again. So this changes to 2. Next, you see the letter B. B can be treated as a 1, right? Since it is the second character. So this changes to 1. Going ahead, you see C. So this would change to 1. And then you have B again. So this changes to 2. So in your frequency map, now you know the frequency of each of the character. Going ahead, you can now start to build your frequency string. What we do is we simply iterate over this frequency array and we append the first character of the alphabet A and then the frequency we find, that is 2. Then we append the character B by doing a character plus plus and then we append the frequency of B. Then again we do a C plus plus, so our character becomes C and we append the frequency of C, that is 1. Going ahead, it will eventually append everything like D0, E0, F0, and so on up till the value Z. Correct? Once this array has been iterated upon, we simply return this frequency string. And this can now be used in our original hash map. Be sure to again check out how the code looked like. I hope I was able to simplify this problem and its solution for you. Note that this is a very important question and it has been asked in a lot of interviews by some of the major tech companies. As per my final thoughts, I want to know what methods did you try, or rather, what problems did you face while coming up with solutions? Were you able to solve this question in an even better time complexity than the methods we already discussed? Let me know your thoughts in the comment section below and I would love to discuss all of them with you. You would be also glad to know that a text-based explanation to this problem is available on the website studyalgorithms.com. I am including a link in the description below in case you want to check it out. Once again, if you found this video helpful, please do consider subscribing to my channel and share this video with your friends. This motivates me to make more and more such videos where I can simplify programming for you. Also, let me know what problem do you want me to solve next. Until then, see ya!